That's what he's saying. Good morning, Luke. I have no idea what it said, I just got... Maybe it's use the force, Luke.
Use the force, Luke.
Good morning, Luke.
Oh, that's the one with the Banff, isn't it?
Yes. And I don't get it. And your health bar's been reduced from nothing for some reason. Like, this bit would be too easy. You had the full health. Yeah, literally, it was running to like the second to last digit on the score, and now it's just been cut short somewhat. Do you reckon any of those Banthas' names are Samantha?
Samantha Bantha.
Yeah.
Quite possible. This is Star Wars.
Get them out. Oh, yeah.
They haven't really made an impression so far. These Banthas.
They sound like Chewie.
Yeah, they look like big, massive Wookiees, don't they?
They do.
They're probably from the same family.
Let's not go see Chewie's family.
From the Christmas special.
Crystal Maze.
Fucking rubbish, that.
What about the Turtles' Christmas?
The Turtles' Christmas?
The live-action Christmas special with the old crazy music.
Oh, yeah.
Not that I've seen it.
Yeah.
But it sounds like Up Your Street. I bet it's got Michael Douglas in there somewhere doing a cameo.
There's nothing wrong with a bit of Doug.
No, the cartoon's amazing, but that's not Michael Douglas. You can put Michael Douglas and funny in the same sentence. What's his dad called?
Darth Vader?
No.
Kirk Douglas.
Oh, yeah.
Kirky O'Dugger.
Probably the easiest thing about this entire game.
Yeah, it is an easy one, isn't it?
I don't remember this at all.
I don't remember it in the movie, but I remember it in this.
I think the levels get more interested in the other two games. There's a particular level I remember in Return of the Jedi where you're like platforming upwards for ages and ages, but it's quite interesting.
Is that the one on Tatooine?
I don't know, you're kind of outside, but you're on a mechanical machine of some sort. I can't remember.
Isn't it a lift? Isn't it the one with the little bears?
Possibly, but it's not
it's
a
like
lift.
A lift, isn't it?
I must be thinking of something different. I don't know, I'd have to rekindle my...
This is basically how you kill this boss people, just jump and hold the shoot button.
Yeah, it's a bit of an insult. If only the other boss... later on, which has a similar attack.
I bet he's stuck red for something like for ages then.
He's like a giant gremlin.
He's a big daddy of that bunny family.
Yeah. Well, we've had enough of you randomly spawning kids.
Hey, here's one there.
He wants revenge.
Spawned out of his dad's belly.
His dad's belly? You want it, you want it, you told me you want it.
Dum bum bum. This is David playing again now. Okay, I got a challenge for you. Name three different movies starring Harrison Ford, excluding Star Wars and Indiana Jones.
Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Excluding
the
Indiana Jones.
Indiana Jones, I thought you said Star Wars.
I said Star Wars and Indiana Jones.
Alright. Well, that becomes a little trickier.
It doesn't.
It does for me. You're putting me on the spot again while I'm trying to play.
You got one.
Yeah, I know, but to be honest, I can't think of many good Harrison Ford films. I'm thinking of that crappy, is it 40 Days and 40 Nights? Just crap like that he's been in, which is
40 Days and 40 Nights.
Is it something like that? I don't know.
You're forgetting Blade Runner, aren't you?
Blade Runner, yeah, yeah. But then
can't
I
say it now.
I've seen that film in years.
I've got that film on my computer. Good. What about What Lies Beneath?
Don't know if I've seen that. I possibly have, but...
It's on the ghost.
Ken, there's not a lot I can comment on. He's just a depressing man's Chevy Chase.
Depressing man's Chevy Chase.
Yeah.
Chevy Chase was never that funny. He was funny in National Lampoon, but other than that, I haven't seen him in anything else.
Have you not?
No, what else has he been in?
Have you seen Fletch?
No.
It's good in Fletch.
I've seen some of his Saturday Night Live sketch things. They were not funny.
This Wookiee's a rat going
around. Maybe it would have been more funny if I was around when he was on Saturday Night Live.
I don't think Saturday Night Live that funny from what I've seen.
Yeah.
Didn't that not have a Wayne's World sketches back in the day?
Yeah, so Wayne's World spawned, wasn't it?
Yeah. I'm shocked.
Well, yeah.
Wayne's World's one of my favourite films.
What's that film you like, the Chinese one, the jumping over the ant?
Jumping over the ant, Fong Sayak. Jet Li.
Terrible.
Can't be a bit of Jet Li.
Terrible,
no, far from it.
Terrible.
I think with you, unless it's something you find yourself, you're not very tolerable to other people's opinions or recommendations.
No, you're right there.
You're like, unless you find it, it's exactly. Like, no, that's rubbish after about 2 minutes.
That's right.
It's like that time I brought my laptop round and you had about 20 second blast on Windows 7. You're like, oh my god, it's rubbish!
I'd been on Windows 7 before.
No.
It wasn't my cup of tea. Too much of a different for my liking.
Well, that's why things change.
I'll stick to XP.
So people who moan on Facebook about it changing. So, why? They've made it rubbish! And then, like, 2 weeks later, everyone's happy again.
I never know what they're talking about half the time. It's stuff that I don't use.
Yeah.
Like the chat and stuff like that.
Ugh, can't be bothered with that, man.
Nah, how can I?
Do
I don't
something.
Even know how to sign into it, to be honest.
I've turned it off.
Never used it. I mean, I put that in the bottom right hand corner, there's a little thing saying, do you want to stay offline? That kind of thing.
Yeah.
I've just left that as offline, so I'm guessing it's that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I just have that off anyway.
I don't want to talk to people directly, you know?
I know.
I'm antisocial.
Alright, we can get flying.
Yeah, he bounces back down.
Whoa!
Can't stay in the air.
Yeah, you can, look at that.
Oh, a bit of talent there. You like flying the... like flying the elevator.
Flying the elevator.
The
plane in
GTA 3.
Yeah. Now that's tougher.
This level goes on for fucking ever.
I know. Alright, stop cheating. See if I can do a level without dying.
Dying, yeah. I don't know what's wrong with you, man.
Die. Alright, I can't shoot past that one.
So what's your favourite Star Wars film, then?
Return of the Jedi.
Why?
I don't know, it's just the most action-packed.
Do you like the motorbikes?
The motorbikes? Oh, the speed things through the forest. That's all good.
Yeah.
That's a really good scene. That's a really memorable scene, actually.
That's the first thing I ever saw, well, but at home, in surround sound.
Really?
I saw it around Marty's house. She was like, check this out. VHS tape in, bam, surround sound.
Did you have the weird THX screaming?
THX. Yeah. I hate that. That scares me. The way it gets louder and louder and louder.
That guy's invincible.
Not the Adam and Joe version, but the actual proper version.
I dodged you, didn't I? No, I'll just get hit by you. I think these sort of old retro sort of shoot 'em up style games aren't my cup of tea. I just don't have the patience for them.
What do you want to play?
I don't know.
Counter-Strike?
No, it's not my cup of tea anymore, either.
Command and Conquer. You shouldn't play retro games.
No, because there's many old games that I like over new stuff. New stuff, I don't know, it's brain dead. When people say, oh, you got to play this game, it's got an amazing story, I'm just like, has it? Because I didn't get that impression. In fact, I'm
has
quite
it?
Bored. Then I was like, oh, you don't know anything.
Who's telling you that?
It's just general opinion amongst most gamers I talk to, especially at uni as well, when they're like, play Mirror's Edge, mate, it's amazing.
You did play Mirror's Edge.
And
you
I played it and
amazing.
I was like, it's alright. I got so frustrated with that game at times.
Yeah,
I get frustrated at everything, but no.
I know, that's you, isn't it? That's your thing. If someone was going to describe you on VG Gameplay, they'd say, oh, that bloke who
ranges
controls and frustration times.
I put the nerd to shame.
I get called a backseat gamer.
Do you?
Yeah. Do you remember on 8-Bit Memoirs playthrough of Batman?
Oh, yeah.
On the NES. Ridiculous. I suppose I am.
Well, I would go as far as to say I've taken a backseat in gaming for the last 4 or 5 years. It's not been something I've been able to keep up with, and I've missed out on a ton of games in this previous
generation.
We're
talking about different backseats now, aren't we?
I know.
you're talking about leaving gaming behind for a bit, and I'm talking about me moaning at someone to do something right. Which
yeah.
I do, actually. People have a go at me on our Donkey Kong Country videos while I'm telling Jenna what to do. I'm like that, David.
I know you are.
She loves it.
No, she doesn't. Assuming we haven't used this for a while.
Shum. It looks purple in this game.
It is. For some crazy ass reason.
Zoom.
She's protecting me a bit better.
You're doing the jump and flip.
Oh yeah.
Jump and flip.
Got a shield. I don't know. I think I've just got a diminished attention span and I don't know if it's curable. And if it ever becomes curable, then I'll probably be able to play more games with a bit more care. But at the minute, I don't know.
You're scared to try anything new.
What? It's not. I'm scared to try anything new.
Sticking to what you know, hence why you bought Zelda.
I bought that because that's a good game, and I know I'd enjoy it again.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Sticking to what you know.
I don't really.
Yes.
I bought Ridge Racer 3D, and I kind of regret that.
And that's why.
Pilot Wings. Although that's a sequel to something I fairly enjoyed. Alright.